Hello my dear Digimon figure fans, this is Mega88 1000 again with another review video which I will have uploaded under my own section of this sub-edition video series. I had already started with my so self-called sub-edition video series reviewing the simpler model kit figures of Paildramon and Paildramon. And also the first of the better model kit series of Digimon Adventure 02, Xvimon. If you remember. Yeah. Now we have them. And in the last video about the Xvimon model kit figure, I also directly ask you to express your own wishes in the comments which figures especially you want to have reviewed again under the somewhat simpler edition video series. I also got a few more requests and I want to thank you for those. I know this last video of this edition video series of also only 3 so far was some time ago for now, and I put this edition vids on hold at first because I had my hands full with creating this retrospective review video series about all the Bandai Tenmachi D Odds, SH Figure Odds, Digimon Collectors, action figures you might know. And yes, there are also some more of these retrospective reviews in my channel to come. But since, from my point of view, all of these videos are finished, and because there are sadly no new announcements by Bandai so far for new figures, yeah, I won't be able to make so many new videos in the near future, so we'll show some more love to this edition video series again to fill the upcoming gap, you know. And so I will pick out one or the other Digimon figure that I think you might be interested in seeing a real on-camera video about again. Because they all got very simple videos in the past. You know? Yeah, and that's why, and you could already see along this far too long intro here, we are moving on to the next or second release of the Better Bandai Digimon Adventure 02 model kit figure series with Paildramon for this next video here. To show Paildramon as next was my own choice, not a request. Just wanted to mention this. Yeah. First of all, I want to show you the box a bit. This is his box. Surprise, surprise. Yeah, that we're starting with something here for this edition review. Also the product images on the box showing the figure with more paint apps. Yeah, but the real figure in real condition not would have those paint apps. We're coming to that later. Also have to mention that thanks to myself, my figure here, also got a few additional paint apps, which this Paildramon model kit figure wouldn't have in its original condition. So the red paint apps on the fingers just would be white and are customized. And the light gray paint apps on the Desperado Blasters are customized, just would be green, like the rest of the plaster. And the matte white paint app for the front section of the neck, I customized myself to give the figure a better look. Yeah. You know, that's what I always done with some of my figures. Yeah. For yeah, give the figure a better overall look. So keep in mind that my Paildramon figure isn't in its original condition as well. So also my figure looks with those additional custom paint apps more like the product shots showing the model kit figure on the box, but they added some more paint apps for the figure for those product shots, which are even not done on my figure, but more about this topic later. And yeah, the more paint apps they give this figure for the product shots, or especially those black paint apps down there for those details and also for the hands, they are gray. Yeah. And you can see for yourself that this Paildramon model kit figure was released in the year 2000 by Bandai Japan. Like the others from this Battle Adventure Zero series, Zero 2 series, and also the ones of the Simpler Model Kit figure series I showed you before. That would be the right side of the box. We have a product shot there with the figure in action, and also the figure in action with some, yeah, effects for shooting and using desperado blasters, nicely staged. And here we also have advertised the number 3 of this battle series, Black War Greymon, as you can see. Unfortunately, there were only 3 figures made for this battle model kit series. Yeah, the left side of the box showing the figure from different angles, as you can see. This is just an, yeah, sticker, maybe from my eBay seller where I got it from back then. That's not the original Bandai sticker, I think. Yeah, you can see this product shots, and the button looks like the lid, same design. And also want to show you, of course, the backside of the box a bit. Because I think it's quite interesting to see this. With a lot of character information, or character bio, and Vimon's evolution line. This picture not showing further available figures. It simply shows all of Vimon's possible evolutions from the anime. Yeah. Because the only ones shown here from this Evo line, and which they made as such an actual model kit figure for this better model kit series, are Paildramon and X-Vimon. I just wanted to mention this again so you're not getting confused by this picture. There were always so much printed on those Japanese boxes, you know, in the sense of pictures of the characters, information and character bios and other things. Yeah, you can see it. And I also want to compare Paildramon's box quick with X-Vimon's box to see the design is very, yeah, the same, just other colors, and of course it's dedicated to the content inside. So yeah, for X-Vimon's box we have X-Vimon all around, and yeah, we have Paildramon for Paildramon's box. Yeah. So much about that. So much about the box, and this was the content of the box. A model kit figure of Paildramon. Surprise, surprise, But yeah. And now, of course, I will show you the actual content, the Paildramon Model Kit Figure here with, yeah, a bit better, with some, with the first rotation. Also, he is very wobbly on his legs because all these joints are very loose, got very loose over the time. They are damaged over the time, so it's very difficult to do a probo review with him. But yeah, I think he will often lose his. We're coming to that point later, why those joints are a bit damaged and not as tight anymore they were before some years ago. We're coming to that topic, just want to show you him a bit in close-ups here, because to see all these details, how they made this Paildramon figure. All the scat works going on here. All the details. All the colored plastic parts. Yeah. He's about losing his left leg. Very often I'm very afraid of this, but yeah, it will happen. Be sure that will happen during this review very often. Yeah. And why do I call this the better model kit figure series? Simply because they were better. They were more advanced and improved over the model kit figures of the more simpler series. Those figures of the better series are more comparable to action figures while having much more articulation. Then in contrary, these model kit figures of the simpler model kit series had before. And for that we let join also another one of the Digimon Adventure 01. Simpler model kit line, Adlock Caputerimon, and one of the 02 simpler model kit line, Stingmon. I also made detailed reviews about those guys, maybe remember some years ago I did this. Yeah, as you also can see, those from the simpler line, well, also a bit smaller proportioned in size, so maybe we should starting with that. Well, the simpler ones were about circa 4.3 inches or 11 centimeters. Of course, it also depends on the pose of the better ones. But roughly the size of those simpler ones is just under 4.3 inches. And Paildramon measures approximately 5.1 inches. Or 13 centimeters in this roughly upright standing pose, like he's standing here, measured from the feet to the top of the horn tip. Paildramon is slightly bigger than Xvimon, you may be seen before. But this also depends on the different character designs. Yeah, in general, you know, yeah, you might think now this isn't much size difference in terms of pure numbers, but you can see that the parts of the simpler model kit figures are a bit slimmer and everything is a bit smaller proportioned on them. In direct comparison, it getting very obvious. And with the better ones like Paildramon and Xvimon, you can see in comparison that those parts of them are much bigger and bulkier, and that's why the figure is bigger than the simpler model kit figures. And this is especially noticeable in comparison to Adlocarbuterimon and Exvimon, for example. Yeah, when you have the two standing next to each other and you imagine that if Adlocarbuterimon would be from the same battle series like the Exvimon figure, yeah, they should be about the same size. But they are not, because they are not from the same series. So much about that. Yeah. Second reason why I call them the better model kit figures is simply because they are incredibly poseable. yeah, in compare to the simpler model kit figures, and for a model kit figure of that time, and in compare to the very less articulated simpler model kit figures before, the better ones even have built-in joints that you have to put in during assembly. Well, you actually got a small instruction sheet as well for those better series, as you can see. Not like with the simpler model kits where they just printed the assembly instructions on the insides of the boxes like I showed you with the others. No, here you have these extra instruction sheets, as you can see. And here I can show you what I meant with the better built-in joints. That would be, yeah, the inside of the body, you can imagine. And there we have such joint sockets and, yeah, those joints where ball joints getting connected to, also hollowed ports getting connected to those, and the joint sockets, those are meant to, yeah, for. Yeah, there you can see it. These kind of joints are like for the head, and those are sockets for those ball joints, those molded on ball packs there. Yeah, I think you can imagine when you're looking at those things, those are all those little joint pieces they you have to build in to achieve a better, yeah, joint system. Yeah, you have seen it in those pictures, so you can imagine what it meant with this. What I meant with this. Many of those little joint pieces to build in and to make the articulation work and be more improved. Something like that they not done for those simpler model kit series or figures before. Yeah. To that I also will bring in Paildramon from the simpler model kit series again. If these only the head and arms were articulated, nothing for the lower body, for the legs, for the feet, nothing. Only head and arm articulation. That's it for those. Mostly. Yeah, compared to Paildramon, you can really guess by turning him a bit around, around and around, you can see and guess on those connections. Like an action figure, he has joints overall his body. Yeah, there we have one. And now you can also see such a gray built in joint socket. There we have it. Yeah, he have it showing, has it showing very well for you. Yeah. They have joints like normal action figures, which those not had. Oh, Paildramon also. Yeah, I would put it this way, these better ones were already more in the style of these new figurized standard model kit figures. In a slightly simpler form, they corresponded more to the figure style of these new ones, though of course the new figurized Digimon are much more articulated and improved. But in compared with these simpler model kits, like Paildramon or Stingmon and all the others from the simpler line, those from the battle series were much more further improved in this point of view, though those and the simpler ones were all released in the same year. And this we will prove with Paildramon's box. Yeah, they made later in the year of 2000 the improved ones, but they are, those simpler ones were also from the year 2000. And we have another difference, because we have less parts, they are smaller. Also, the boxes of the simpler model kit figure line or series were smaller than the from the better model kit series. Another feature of the simpler model kit figures is another thing especially noticeable on Stingmon. Also, Stingmon is extremely customized, by the way. You may notice through his review I done about him, and also done those painting updates. But yeah, another feature is that everything is much more open looking, those simpler. Yeah, from the rear side they are more open. Everywhere there is big gaps on the legs and the arms, and they just looking only perfect in quotation marks from the front. Yeah. And as you can see or seen on Paildramon, everything is more filled out on him, real molded body and armor pieces all around, because the better kits consisting out of more single pieces. Here you only have those open gap feature on the feet and the lower tail section, as you can see. Everything is even more filled out on Paildramon than in comparison on Xvimon. Xvimon has more gaps, but I think that gets really obvious that Stingmon here has much of those gaps looking at him from the back. Yeah. So the simpler ones had more of those big gaps and only had the perfect look from the front, like I said before. So this is another reason for why those from the better series are just better. Yeah, that's a simple thing to understand, I think. And before we going on with the review here, I also wanted to do a better setting here to get the figure more in the focus here. Just like that. Another feature why they are better, especially to see on Paildramon XVmon for example, is that their parts are all molded already from these correct colors, molded from better and more colored runners. That in contrary what I showed you with the simpler model kits, like with Lightramon or Flamedramon, yeah, or Flatramon, he's a Japanese model kit, so I should call him Flatramon. Yeah, those had in contrary less painted parts because they are simpler in their original state, because they are extremely customized. In this case, mine are extremely customized, but in original state there are much paint apps missing and also body parts wrong colored. I'll show you again. Flatramon's head, for example, was molded from white plastic. Olightramon is missing the white lower section on the head and neck, which I customized, all the white claws, which I customized, and so on. Though you had many stickers for the other paint apps, but you also had many wrong colored sections or missing paint apps. So in this sense, I say even if that is not expressed quite correctly, the better ones simply had more paint apps in contrary, or rather all parts were already molded from the right colored plastic or runners, as you would rather wish. In addition, in the original state, Lightramon's complete body was originally molded out of a wrong colored gray plastic, but the figure was shown with an overall more black colored body on the box, which not showed the actual real look of the figure inside. Because mine are extremely customized, they are now looking much better than they showing them on the box or the original look was. This fact you should consider by that as well. Yeah, and the whole armor of Raytramon was just like this. Dark gray. Real dark gray. I also can show you the box pictures of Lightramon there. Look how much I customized him. How much paint apps are missing, and the black color wasn't even black, like I said before. All the armor parts were colored gray. Yeah. And as you have seen for yourself, the boxes of the simpler model kits, on the boxes of the simpler model kits, they not looked like those, because they have They made more colored, right colored runners, so the ports are in the right colors, which was not the topic on those simpler model kits. Also in Flamedramon, I customized the head tube blue because it was completely white. The neck I customized, also customized the metallic silver there. Yeah, they are extremely customized. I told you in those reviews of them that the boxes were bigger of the better ones. I already said before, this is just another difference between the simpler and the better ones. And I also told you about the from the simpler model kit series that it cost about 300 yen. Yeah, at least the box showing this. We're proving this once again with the box. Unfortunately, there is no yen price printed on the better model kits boxes. Yeah, so I can't tell you what they cost in Japan back then. However, I think they were certainly a bit more expensive because they were better and consisted of more parts compared to those of the simpler series. I've already mentioned this several times before now, so we should moving on to the next here. Yeah, so if you want the Paildramon model kit figure, this is still the only and therefore the best one so far. Again, not considering today's eBay scalpers prices by that. That also counts for XVmon. For the rest of what needs to be painted, you either have these parts molded of the right colored plastic. And for the rest of most of the missing paint apps, you have these typical stickers again. Therefore, we had sticker sheet, of course. Yeah, and we had stickers for Paildramon, for the white chest and abdomen section with the gray colored symbol. This is one big sticker. Like I said before, the front section of the neck is customized. I painted, just would be blue. Sticker goes just till the neck. Yeah, and the white details for the head, helmet are stickers. Those two sections there are stickers. Eyes and both black paint apps on the helmet are stickers, and the shoulder spikes are white stickers. Yeah, as I mentioned before, in the official product images on the box, the figures are shown with more paint apps and looking better from the coloring point than the actual Paildramon kit figure would have looked in its original condition. So all product images not showing the figure's original condition or look. In XVmon's model kit figure review, I said things about this like, don't know if they photoshopped those product shots, because not showing the original look of the figure. So it's like that they pretty much fooled us with those better box pictures. I imagine that they might have originally planned to make stickers for such missing paint apps. And that could have been a possibility and one reason for why those model kit figures looking better on the boxes pictured than encountering the actual content of the boxes looks. Could be a reason. But you could probably, I said this in XVMon's video, but you could probably see the better looking figures like they shown them on the box as a personal suggestion that you could give the figures a custom paint job yourself. You can paint and improve them with a few additional paint apps because it's a model kit if the original look is not enough. I said something similar in XVMon's edition video and I would update this now for this video with this fresh thought what I said about right before, because with the new figurized model kits they even printing the complete color guide in the instructions for those who generally want to paint their kit with better colors or completely. Yeah, but compared to the model kits of the simpler series and how much colors were wrong and missing on those in the original condition, this was quite an improvement for the model kits of the better series here, even in their original condition with some more missing paint apps. You know, these better ones just looked already better compared to the other simpler ones' general look. In the original condition, yeah, we had this before, very detailed, showed you this on the boxes with the figures. I explained it, I think it's enough. Also in terms of modeling sculpt, the model kits of the better series have much better overall sculpt. All of these details are better sculpted. The way the arms are sculpted. Everything is much more detailed than it's in contrary with the arm sculpt. The simpler Paildramon model kit figure where everything looks simpler, even a bit more roughly proportioned in comparison. On the better ones, it's all the muscles, body much more defined, more natural looking, and armor parts are more detailed. You know what I mean. I think you can see this for sure. It is also hinted on the simpler ones, but here with the better model kit figures, it was on a completely different level, I would say. And you can see for yourself how many sculpted details are obvious on those various body and armor parts here on Paildramon. Making quick, especially on the arms, some quick close-ups. Think in the direct comparison, it's getting really obvious that those looking better. We can even have another display option with Paildramon with this, his Desperado blasters in use, despite different poses, which I will quickly demonstrate. It's a bit simpler, but a typical feature with Paildramon figures back then. You can just switch the position of those Desperado blasters like this, attach it the other way around, and there he can use them. It works, it's a bit simpler, but it works, and it's a nice little gimmick they gave this model kit figure, which is not bad at all. Or what do you think? If he still gets the balance back? Yeah. There we have it. Can use his Desperado blasters like this. Unfortunately, the previously mentioned built-in joints are no longer quite as tight because they are made of the softer rubber-like material and therefore had become a bit brittle over the time. That's what I meant with, yeah, they are damaged. And most of them are also partially torn, which is why they no longer as tight and not holding the figure's set poses so well anymore and making the whole figure pretty much shaky after 24 years. That is the little flaw or issue about this joint design and how they made it back then. As a result, the figure barely holds the set poses when everything was tighter. When they were newer, the tightness of this joint system was actually pretty good, and so was the posing. Yeah, I showed you this before. He showed it himself, so I won't lose any more words about that. Yeah, and of course I will also demonstrate the whole articulation of this Paildramon model kit figure with the articulation demonstration. But before we starting with the articulation demonstration, I just want to show you actual figure with the Desperado blasters in use, a bit of a close up, and yeah, because I want to build this back, put it back in the original or in the standard position. So you see the switch again, but it's very easy, just have holes and pegs there, and there we go. And there we have another of those, yeah, torn joint circuit, as you can see. That's why the leg nut stays on anymore. This, well, as you see, yeah, but articulation demonstration, the head can move up and down like this and also rotate like this. If that nut works with the leg on, we have to ignore it. The arms would can do the free full 360. They are connected to a ball pack, so they are can be angled every direction you want. Inwards, a bit outwards, yeah, that's it. We have even at the elbow, yeah, here we have another built-in joint there, such a joint socket. There. Okay, we all not needing this for the articulation demonstration, I'm sorry. Yeah, the elbow, it has a kind of elbow swivel. There is such another great joint piece there at the connection, so we have another joint built in joint piece there. We have an elbow swivel and also a bit of bending action there. Yeah, the fingers are a bit articulated like this, not much, but yeah, the hip can rotate. We even have such a joint piece there to do such bending actions with the body, ab crunch. Yeah, and for the legs, you can see we have this ball pack with the joint socket there, and that allows splits like that for also kicking action there, kicking backwards as well if you turn rotate this blasters a bit away, but they are not on yet. Yeah, bit of angling action, how you wish it. We have a bit of knee bend, also another joint connection there. We have a ball pack for the feet. Then we can rotate the feet. Bit of angling actions as you want to have it. Yeah. And I think we have also, I think we are through with articulation demonstration, but we have another articulation for the tail. Can be rotate straight and a bit sidewards. Nothing at the base. It's not rotatable at the base because it's, yeah, connected with a peg there, just with a peg, no rotation, but we have at least this segmented section there where we can do such movements. Yeah, the wings are not articulated, and I think we are through with the articulation demonstration. Now we have to get him back to force him to stand again with the leg on. Yeah, you have seen it. By that you could also see those gray color bitted in joints and joint sockets I showed you, which I tried to explain to you in the instructions. Yeah. You've seen them on the other connections. Yeah, and such bitted in joints not had those simpler model kit figures. The simpler kit figures not had such joints. They just solved it with, yeah, those had only recesses in the body, which were each adapted to the size of the ball, the molded on ball peg joint there, and that's it. So those were more improved with those better joints. That's why those joints were even much more loose. So much for the difference again. So he is nicely poseable compared to these simpler model kit figures, and therefore is more like an action figure than the other simpler ones ever were before, because they have more joints, more articulation. That's the big fact here. Like mentioned just right before, it's more like an action figure, so for model kit figures for that time, they were incredibly good articulated. Sadly, there were only three made. That's the little downside about the whole thing here. And the remake in the current new figurized standard anime design series would be more than very desirable for Paildramon. What do you think? And also for all others they made in the past, and also for the armor level Digimon, such as Lightramon, Flaytramon, and also all armor level Digimon which never got a figure in the past, like, yeah, Nefertimon, Pegasmon, and so on. This is something I really would like to see, and that there are much more to come after figurized anime design, Magnamon. Yeah. And because with the today's standards, those would look and be, of course, much, much better than all of the old ones. In any case, and in many respects, a very, very cool model kit figure of Paildramon for that time. And since the paint apps here are also correct, apart from the few missing ones, and he also looks very good in his original condition already, it's a better and more detailed figure of the character Paildramon Then the action feature Paildramon action figure from back then was and is. I just can't show you him for comparison because I don't have it. But for comparison, I can show you some other matching 02 action feature figures like Vimon. Moment, please. Vimon and Roman. And also action feature Flamedramon. And also action feature Raydramon. Yeah. And you can see that these better model kit figures, also the simpler ones, were much bigger than those 2-inch. Yeah. 2.5 inches or 5 centimeters tall action feature figures, which were much smaller in compare. As you can see, it's getting really obvious here. Also want to do another compare with the back then bigger and better action figures of Paildramon. Do you read Paildramon, the Japanese version of this figure, and our Deutsche Warrior version of this figure? Yeah. To see how they are looking together. And I also want to show you him with the transforming Japanese figure version, Chokras Evolution figure of X-Vimon and Stingmon combined to Paildramon's form here. But we have complications again with Paildramon model kit figure. And I have to switch the position a bit here to get him in focus, just to see how they are looking together. He is big, he is bulky against the model kit, but there you have it. You haven't seen it. Then quickly doing the compare with his third line mate of the better three model kit figures of Adventure 02 with Black War Greymon here. I also painted most on him myself. Worst kit of the three, and X-Vimon is the only one where... yeah. I had the less customizing works to do. On him I only painted the hand claws. Yeah. Maybe I'm picking the old Black War Greymon model kit figure for the next edition video review, but this I will keep shorter about him because coloring wise he wasn't good and the worst kit of the three, and because the new figurized standard anime design Black War Greymon model kit figure exists now, which is much, much better than this old one in compare. Yeah. Speaking of the new figurized standard model kit line, I also want to show you him with figurized anime design Magnamon to see how they are looking together. And for a more collector's action figure compare, I also want to show you Paildramon model kit with the original release of SH Figure Arts Paildramon Fighter Mode by Bandai Imaginations to see how they are looking together. I think they scaling very well together. Yeah, and so we are done with the comparisons. As I said, it's a very, very nice Paildramon figure. Not necessarily better as the D-Real Paildramon, but one of the best articulated Paildramon figures Bandai ever made. Also in terms of all the proportions which corresponded more to the action figure style of the time, especially that of the bigger action figures like the D-Real or the Digivario series, and less to the simpler model kit figure style. It was and still is a very, very cool figure of Paildramon. I think that can't be said often enough. It just would need a new remake, like all the others in the Figurize anime design Digimon series now. Or what do you think? And please, listening Bandai, please, listening to my words here. Yeah, as I mentioned at the beginning, you are welcome to write me in the comments your suggestions with figures you want or would like to see reviewed again under the smaller edition video series, like these model kits from the past. Or maybe also mainly these figures where I made these very simple videos about and which never got such a better video before. Yeah, something like that. For example, you could wish for this edition video series. Just write me in the comments down below your wishes and suggestions which you would like to have reviewed again in this form. I am very open for your personal requests because I would like to involve you a bit more as my viewers and subscribers, especially in this edition video series. Yes, and I think I will end this video now because I think I have said everything about this Paildramon model kit figure now. That's it, and it got very long. Anyways, so yeah, I'm saying goodbye to you and thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please hit the thumbs up button, and if you like my channel, please feel free to subscribe. I do appreciate all of this. Until the next video, your Mega88 1000.